Good morning students, welcome back to saradamathschannel, and this is the continuation video of the integration to max problems maths 2b and video number 3. And the students who will follow these videos will definitely attempt all the 2 marks questions in the coming public examinations 2022. So all of you once watch this video and solve all these problems. Okay, let us start the class. So the first problem, integral 1 by 8 plus 2x square into dx. So first I take the given question here, integral 1 by 8 plus 2x square into dx. First, the first step is we have to take the x square quotient common here from the denominator. So what is the x square quotient here? We have 2. So taking that number first here, so this is 1 by 2 into 4 plus x square into dx, which is equals to 1 by 2 into integral 1 by 4 plus x square into dx. Okay, and in the next step I take this 4 as the 2 square. So this is 1 by 2 into integral 1 by 2 square plus x square into dx. Now clearly this is in the form of the integral 1 by a square plus x square into dx, where a is the constant here, and here we have that a is equals to 2. Now what is the formula for integral 1 by a square plus x square into dx? The formula is 1 by a tan inverse x by a plus c. So this is the formula. Now I am applying that formula here to this value. So this is equals to, already here we have 1 by 2 del. So first write that value into. Now applying the formula to this one. So this is 1 by a. But what is a value here? We have 1 by a is equals to 2. 1 by 2 tan inverse of x by a. X by a value 2 plus a. Therefore the answer is equal to 1 by 4 tan inverse of x by 2 plus a. That's all. This is the answer. Most important model. Okay, see the next problem. The second question. Integral 2 by square root of 25 plus 9x square into dx. Okay, first I am taking the given question here, integral 2 by square root of 25 plus 9x square into dx. What is the first step to this type of problems? First we have to take the x square quotient common from the denominator, that is 2 by square root of, what is the x square quotient? 9. So taking that value common, so the first value becomes 25 by 9. There is no 9 here to take common 9 from this term. So we take the convert the first term as to 25 by 9. Okay. Plus after taking 9 common here from the second term, we get that this value is equals to x square is equals to integral 2 by root 9 is equal to 3 into square root of this 25 by 9 is nothing but 5 by 3 whole square. Okay. This 25 by 9 is equals to 5 by 3 whole square into dx plus x square into dx. Now this is the constant 2 by 3, so, and I am writing the constant before the integration here. So this becomes 2 by 3 into integral 1 by square root of 5 by 3 whole square plus x square into dx. Now clearly this is in the form of the integral 1 by square root of a square plus x square into dx. And what is the formula for the integral 1 by a square plus x square into dx? The formula is sin h inverse x by a plus c. This is the formula. The formula is sin h inverse x by a plus c. Now I am applying that formula here. So this becomes 2 by 3 into sin h inverse x by a value is equal to 5 by 3. X by 5 by 3 plus c. And that is equals to 2 by 3 into sin h inverse of, writing this 3 at the numerator, so this becomes sin h inverse of 3x by 5 plus c. That's all. This is the answer. Understand all of you? Okay, see the next problem. Integral 3 by square root of 9x square minus 1 into dx. Okay, solution. First I am writing the given question here. Integral 3 by square root of 9x square minus 1 into dx. And what is the first step? First, we have to take the x square quotient common from the denominator. That is, here x square quotient is equal to 9. Now, taking that 9 common, so this becomes x square minus 1 by 9. 1 by 9 into dx. Just taking that 9 common from the denominator. is equals to integral 3 pi root 9 becomes 3 only here, 3 into, now writing the square to the remaining term, x square minus this 1 by 9 is nothing but 1 by 3 whole square, 1 by 3 whole square into dx. Now this becomes only integral 1 by square root of x square minus 1 by 3 whole square into dx. Now clearly this is in the form of the integral 1 by square root of x square minus a square into dx, and the formula for this term is cos h inverse x pi plus c. Now simply applying that formula here, so this is, so clearly this is in the form of the 1 by square root of x square minus a square, where a is equal to 1 by 3, and the formula is cos h inverse x pi a plus c, that is cos h inverse of x pi, what is a value, 1 by 3 plus c. Therefore the answer is equals to cos h inverse, writing this 3 at the numerator, cos h inverse of 3x plus c. That's all. This is the answer. Okay, see the next problem. Integral square root of 16 minus 25 x square into dx. So this is the given question. Integral square root of 16 minus 25 x square into dx. And what is the first step? So first, taking that x square quotient common from this term, that is here x square quotient is only, just to take the only positive number, not the sign here. Just only take the 25 common, not minus 25. It is enough to take the only 25 here. So the first term becomes only 16 by 25 minus x square. Okay. Not completely x square quotient, only the plus value. Only take the plus value common. Is equals to integral root 25 is equal to 5 into square root of, I take the 16 by 25 as 4 by 5 whole square. 4 by 5 whole square minus x square into dx. And in the next step, write the constant before the integration. So this becomes 5 into integral square root of 4 by 5 x, 4 by 5 whole square minus x square into dx. Now clearly this is in the form of the square root of integral square root of a square minus x square into dx. And square root of a square minus x square into dx is equals to x by 2 into square root of a square minus x square plus a square by 2 into sine inverse of x by a plus c. This is the formula to this term. Now applying this one to this above question, that is equals to 5 into. So see here, clearly this is in the form of the square root of a square minus x square, a, where a is equal to 4 by 5. So applying this one, x by 2. What is x value? X is nothing but x here. X by 2 into square root of a square minus x square. That is 4 by 5 whole square minus x square plus a square by 2. A square is equal to 4 by 5. 4 by 5 whole square by 2 into sine inverse of x by a. X by, what is a value? 4 by 5. X by 4 by 5 plus c. That's all. And this is equals to 5 into x by 2 into square root of 4 by 5 minus whole, 4 by 5 whole square minus x square plus 4 square equals to 16 by 5 square 25, 25 into 2 is equals to 50. So this becomes 16 by 50 into sine inverse of, writing this 5 at the numerator, so this becomes 5x by 4 plus c. That's all. This is the answer. Understand all of you? Okay, so the next problem. Integral square root of 9x square minus 25 into dx. Now answer. So first take the given question here. Integral square root of 9x square minus 25 into dx. And this is equals to integral. The first step is taking 9 common from this step. So this becomes 9 into x square minus 25 by 9 into dx. And this is equals to integral. Root 9 is equal to 3. 3 into square root of x square minus 25 by 9 is nothing but 5 by 3 whole square into dx. And this is equals to 3 into integral square root of x square minus 5 by 3 whole square into dx. Okay. And this is equals to. So see here, this is in the form of the integral square root of x square minus a square into dx. And the formula for this one is x by 2 into square root of x square minus a square minus a square by 2 into cos h inverse of x by a. So this is the formula for this term. Now I am applying this formula to this question. Okay. So this is 3 into, so clearly this is in the form of the integral square root of x square minus a square, where a is equal to 5 by 3. Now applying the formula x by 2, the first term is x by 2 into square root of x square minus a square, where a is equal to 5 by 3, 5 by 3 whole square minus a square by 2, 5 by 3 whole square by 2 into cos h inverse of x by a, x by 5 by 3, cos h inverse of x by 5 by 3 plus c, and this is equals to 3 into x by 2 into square root of x square minus 5 by 3 whole square minus 5 square 25, 3 square 9, 9 2s are 18, so this entire constant becomes 25 by 18 into cos h inverse. So writing this 3 at the numerator, so this becomes 3x by 5 plus a. That's all. This is the answer, and I will continue the remaining sums in the next video.